Hey guys, let's understand the core competencies analysis is strategic framework for value chain analysis. Core competency is a distinctive or unique skill or technological know-how that creates distinctive customer value. The core competency of Google is its capability to deliver excellent search results which could not be imitated by its competitors. The core competencies are a function of the collective skill set of people, organization structure, resources, and technological know-how. A core competency is the primary source of an organization's competitive advantage. The competitive advantage could result from cost leadership or product differentiation. For more details of product differentiation and cost leadership are part of video part 14 and 15 of this chapter only. There are three tests useful for identifying a core competence. First one is end product benefits. That means product is different from the competitors or having better quality or better features. And that make it organization's core competency. Second one is access to a wide variety of markets. Access to number of markets provide an opportunity to organization to fetch more customers. And the third test is difficult for competitors to imitate, right? The loss of core competencies could be disaster for firms. Nokia was a leader in the feature phones segment till smartphones were introduced. The changing dynamics of industry meant that Nokia lost the top position in mobile phone industry and led to sell off the business to Microsoft. Bajaj Auto, who had core competency in the scooter segment, lost traction when motorbikes were introduced. It is thus important that the firms continuously evolve their core competencies and remain relevant in the ever-changing business environment. Understood? Core competencies stem from two sources, namely resources and capabilities. Let's first understand resources. Resources are factors that enable a company to create value for customers. They can be tangible, like land, buildings, inventory, machinery, money, etc. Or intangible, like employees' skill, brand, patent, technology, etc. The more difficult a resource is to imitate, the more valuable is the resource for the company. The algorithms used by Google to deliver search results are not easily imitated by competitors. Similarly, the secret formula of concentrates used by soft drinks manufacturers like Coca-Cola are hard to copy, right? Capabilities refer to the company's ability to coordinate resources and put them to productive use. Availability of resources by themselves does not guarantee core competency and success. Capabilities stem from organizational structure, processes, and control systems. Applying the value chain approach to core competencies for competitive advantage includes the following steps. First step is validate core competencies in current business. Core competences must lead to a competitive advantage to the business and the existence of core competences be validated continuously, as competency which is better at a time may not be the same after some time. Second step is leverage competences to the value chains of other existing businesses. A core competency in one segment of business can be used in another existing or new business. An excellent distribution network in one business can be used to launch another product. For example, if a bank has a wide network of branches in its banking business, the same network can be used to launch and sell insurance products, right? Third step is to use core competencies to reconfigure the value chains of existing businesses. While firms may manage their existing value chains better than their competitors, sophisticated firms work harder on using their core competencies to reconfigure the value chain to improve payoffs. Otherwise, competitors may exploit opportunities. Example of Tetra Pak is given in the module which has used core competencies to reconfigure the value chain. For filling, it makes container on site using specialized equipment. Even for transportation, refrigerated trucks are not required. For retail display, no need to refrigerate and hence less storage space required, which lowers the storage handling cost. Shelf life is longer comparatively, hence more beneficial to customers. In short, nil wastage in filling and packing, no need to refrigerate, and less space is required. It is cost beneficial to the company, right? Fourth step is to use core competencies to create new value chains. With strong core competencies in its existing businesses, an organization can seek new customers by developing new value chains. For example, FedEx transferred its expertise in the delivery of small packages to contract new business with L.L. Bean for overnight distribution. Understood? Hope you are clear with the concept. Hope you have learned from this video. So please like and share the video, comment if you have any doubt or a suggestion, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Keep watching, keep learning. In short, it is quick. Thank you.